This is TradeFlow News, bringing you relevant news and insights from around the world. TradeFlow News, enabling trade for SMEs and economies worldwide.
These are some of the key topics that we will be looking into in today's program.
First, let's take a look at the overnight headlines which are impacting the commodity markets.
OPEC Plus is monitoring developments around the new coronavirus variant, sources said on Friday, with some expressing concern that it may worsen the oil market outlook less than a week before a meeting to set policy. The Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries and Allies, known as OPEC Plus, is already facing a release of oil stocks led by the United States to try to cool prices. Still, a source said Russia, a key OPEC Plus member, was not concerned about the virus variant yet. OPEC Plus has resisted U.S. calls to do more to lower oil prices, continuing to unwind last year's record output curbs by adding 400,000 barrels of supply per day every month since August. Next week's meeting will discuss January's output.
Asian liquefied natural gas, LNG, prices inched lower this week on concerns over the potential impact of a new coronavirus variant, but were still supported by higher heating demand and tight shipping availability. The average LNG price for January delivery into Northeast Asia LNG slipped to $36.10 per metric million British thermal units, MMBTU, down 60 cents, or 1.6% from the previous week, industry sources said. Prices remain just $2.40 shy of the record level observed in mid-October. Prices for February delivery were estimated around $35.15 per MMBTU, they added.
Moving on to the top news in the energy sector.
Germany's new energy transition plan is unlikely to have a big impact on prices in Europe's carbon market, analysts said on Friday, despite plans to introduce a minimum carbon price domestically. The incoming German coalition government on Wednesday announced plans to ideally bring forward Germany's coal exit to 2030, from a previous target of 2038, and said it could introduce a minimum domestic carbon price of 60 euros ton if a floor price cannot be implemented at an EU-wide level. The benchmark EU carbon allowance, EUA, price rocketed to a record high above 75 euros a ton on Thursday, which some market participants attributed to bullish sentiment surrounding the German announcement.
Oil prices plunged $10 a barrel on Friday, their largest one-day drop since April 2020, as a new variant of the coronavirus spooked investors and added to concerns that a supply surplus could swell in the first quarter. Oil fell with global equities markets on fears the variant could dampen economic growth and fuel demand. The World Health Organization has designated the new variant, which it named Omicron, as of concern, according to the South African health minister. Next, we have the top news in metal markets. A possible ban on exports of bauxite from Indonesia as soon as next year will have little impact on China's aluminium industry because abundant alternative supply from Guinea is available, state-backed Chinese research house Antake said. Indonesian President Joko Widodo on Wednesday said the Southeast Asian country could stop allowing exports of bauxite, the main aluminium ore, from 2022 as it looks to process more of its resources at home. Jakarta previously banned bauxite exports in 2014, before which Indonesia was China's biggest supplier, only to allow them to resume in 2017.
Communities in Peru's Ayacucho region say they will resume protests against the mining sector if the government of leftist President Pedro Castillo breaches what they call a signed agreement to shutter mines, local leaders told Reuters. Prime Minister Mirtha Vasquez said last week that the government would not approve extensions for four mines over environmental concerns raised by local communities. On Wednesday, authorities softened their public stance, saying the mines could seek permission to extend operations. President Pedro Castillo came to power in July, with the backing of poor communities, who say the mines have deprived him of adequate water supplies and to whom he promised greater benefits.
We will now look at the top news in the agricultural sector.
Incomplete wheat export data from France, the European Union's biggest supplier, for the last 4 months because of a technical glitch has angered traders as they try to track supply and demand in the face of lower stocks and record prices. The technical problem at the country's customs service that submits data for France to the European Commission is becoming a major issue as the EU experiences a brisk start to the 2021-22 export season. EU wheat prices hit record prices this week as potential rain damage to Australia's harvest raised the prospect of more EU exports than expected.
That is all for today's news on commodity markets. Stay tuned to TradeFlow News as we continue to provide you with more updates. We also invite you to follow us on Twitter at TradeFlow News, which allows you to watch our program on your mobile device or desktop to receive information from there.